Hi, this is Rich. Welcome to my blog. somebody recently said, "Hey, Rich, don't cuss on." He says, "My children are watching. Don't cuss." Another lady said, "Hey, Rich, can you get to the fucking point?" I think better if I get to the fucking point. Any other requests? I got a lot of questions. Somebody asked about suicide. What do you think, Rich? Somebody else asked me, about how to get out of body and different things like that. I love reading these. For the last hour, I've been reading comments, replies under my videos. I really love it, and I try to get back as soon as I can, if I can. So yeah. Get to the point fast. Are you fucking kidding? I've tried that. It doesn't work for me. Come on. You know, if I talk about, is the world flat? If somebody's waiting for me to get to the point, well, Rich, what do you think? Is it flat? Is it flat? Is it fucking flat? They get to the end of a fucking hour of video, and they still didn't get an answer out of me. I don't fucking know. Why didn't you say that in the first 5 fucking seconds? Well, I guess I could have. Suicide, Rich, what do you think of suicide? It wasn't the same person that asked me about suicide asked me to get to the fucking point in the first, just immediately, right? Different requests. But come on. I'm a talker. I'm not a point maker, right? Okay? So, yeah, suicide? Hey, if I'm in, just for example, it's a broad, commit suicide, well, under what circumstances, right? There's a lot of philosophy here. There's a lot of different opinions and takes on the whole go, fucking kill yourself thing. There's one circumstance is a, young kid totally depressed because people are treating the little thing really, really bad. An older, wiser person. Good luck for this little kid to find one. If the little kid had an older, wiser person around in the first fucking place as a role model, they probably wouldn't be so depressed they want to kill themselves anyway. But the point is, if a little kid, a young teenager, is feeling this suicidal shit, is it right or wrong? Well, it's not about right or wrong. It's about an older, wiser person would know that that feeling will probably pass. So give it some time, and things will get better. It's kind of, that's an approach. But, and that's just one small part of that question and that issue. But if somebody's, in total fucking agony, it's over, and they're just trapped in a physical body. It's totally painful to be in. If that were me, I would want somebody to buy me a gun and put it on my table, okay? And step away from the bedroom. Just go away. I'll do this while you're somewhere else. So, anyway, my point here is that the whole thing about suicide, it's going to be different for everybody in every circumstance. And I personally believe that most people think about fucking off on themselves a lot over the years. More than once, I should say. And it's different from doing it, okay? So, I don't think it's not a don't feel bad, wrong, or guilty if you've thought about it. It's like, Because people who are thinking about suicide are not thinking about a problem. They're thinking about a fucking solution to the problem. They know what the problem is. This place sucks. That's the fucking problem. Okay? So, yeah. So, what happens if you commit suicide? Because I've done a lot of this out-of-body stuff, and I've read a lot of books on going out-of-body, and a lot of people have written to me about going out-of-body and near-death experiences and these different books and past life regression stuff. You read a lot about what happens after a person dies, right? And so, do they die from their own hand, or did somebody else fucking kill them? So you get a lot of feedback, right? It doesn't matter. It's in the afterlife, that's not the thing. If you're a religious person and you have a huge belief system in place and a big guilt trip and you still want to off yourself, and if a person does with that religious baggage, yeah, they're probably going to run into some shit. They're going to run into other beings on the other side who feel and think and believe the way they do, the way the person that off themselves does, and they're going to, you know, interact with those. And I say unload the religion and just learn more about the afterlife and the multidimensionality of reality. And if you can hold off on your little plan, just give it a few days and see if you feel better, right? It's probably, I would say that most people are going to want to fucking kill themselves because of, well, of course, circumstances, but it's either going to be there in emotional or physical pain. And the emotional pain, I'm not saying I have solutions, you know, how to fix it, but it's going to probably be because of who you are connected with, who you are associated with, who are the people in your life. And it's the people in your life that is causing the problem. There's an issue there. It's normally going to be someone you want to get away from and you'll feel better. But sometimes, especially with the lost loved one, you know, somebody has a lover and the lover dumps you, or you dump the, not, no, not that way. If a person gets dumped, yeah, they might be thinking. But most of the time it's going to be because you're around people that are not emotionally healthy for you. And the best thing to do is, if you possibly could, is to get away from them. Of course, that's incredibly simplistic because, duh, they would. You know, people usually get that. You know, I shouldn't be around this people. I shouldn't be in this environment. I got to get away from these people in this environment and chill. So, yeah, there's that. And the physical pain thing, you know, it's just a fucking solution. Suicide's just a solution to get over the pain. So, yeah. So, whether a person commits suicide or not, it's not a big deal on the other side. Now, is it a big deal on this side? Oh, yeah, it's a big deal. There's lots of rules and a lot of emotional shit going down, and a lot of people are very strong in their beliefs and philosophy about you or me or somebody else offing themselves. We'd be out of here. It's like, whew, done. Usually. That will be the way it works. Oh, good. All better now. Right? But the people on the other side are going to be having a fucking shit fit. How could you do? It could get weird in all kinds of ways, you know. But sad and dramatic and just all kinds of things. So, yeah, there's a lot involved there. But once you get on the other side, not so much. However, there's this book called Stephen Lives. Stephen hung himself on a tree out in the woods and immediately changed his mind. Too late. Too fucking late. Oh, man. And his strong-willed kid. Oh, he was a teenager. And he was able to psychically talk to his mom. And so his mom, Stephen and his mom, Stephen on the other side, mom on this side, wrote the book, Stephen Lives. So that's a very interesting look at what can happen if you off yourself. Okay. Stephen just did it. Just did all the wrong things, man. But I was like, hey, thanks, Stephen, for the heads up. Don't fucking hang yourself. Got it. He said he didn't die right away. He's sitting there in fucking agony for, I don't know, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, an hour, I don't know, until he fucking died, right? Mm-hmm. And then when he finally dies, you have to read the book to get the actual story. This is just my retelling of the story. I don't quite remember clearly. Finally, his body dies, and so he's out, but he doesn't want to be out. So he tries to go back into his dead body. Oh, well, I'm reading this, I'm going, that's disgusting, man. What are you fucking doing, dude? Oh. And it's like, you know, okay. So then he gets over on the other side, and the beings in the, he arrives in this his own belief system territory, his afterlife place, different for different people, right? So he's over there, and it's like, they're there to help, right? And whether this is like that, go to the light, you know, don't go to the light, you know, afterlife shit, this isn't a story about that. This is, that's there. Not everybody gets involved in that go to the light, don't go to the light thing, that life review thing. You know, this is a different story. Okay. So Stephen's with his guides, his buds. They're going to try to help him get comfortable with being dead. Steve, you're dead. They don't really say it like that, because you're not dead, right? But yeah, hey, dude, get over it. You're dead. All right, let's move on. No, he doesn't want to. He wants to go. He changed his mind. He wants to be with his mom. So he's just persistent as hell. So I forget the details. I finally couldn't stand it anymore. Jesus, put the book away. But he was able to reach his mom and communicate with her and share the story. And I, for one, appreciate the story. Thank you, Stephen. Thank you, Mom. Okay. It sheds a lot of light on the whole teen suicide thing, but also what can happen afterward. But it's also kind of a little scare story, which isn't so good, because it's not going to be, you know, not everybody's going to be going through it like Stephen did. So yeah, that's my story. This is suicide. Good, bad, right, wrong, what do we do? Okay, now I was going to talk some more about all kinds of other shit, but somebody said make a point and get it over with. Don't talk so fucking much. Didn't actually say it. I mean, didn't write that. I just kind of plugged that in. But yeah, so I'm going to make this short. This is, for me, it's a short video, 15 minutes. So yeah, thanks for watching. And I want to mention that in about 4 days from now, this is coming up Saturday, I'm doing a soul contract revocation boot camp live, interactive on camera, so people can sign up if they want to learn how to do soul contract revocations. Go to richwest.net, sign up, and we're going to be live on video. I'll be there live, and you can ask questions and everything. And I will teach you how to do the soul contract stuff. It can help with the afterlife thing. Also, the suicide thing. If you got some suicide, if you're thinking about it too much, you can shake it. You can, because thinking about it's one thing, and doing it is a completely different thing. But just thinking about it can be a drag. If you're like, God, I keep thinking about it, suicide. What's the matter with me? Well, there's some soul contract agreement sort of things that can be in place that you can revoke and get rid of, and you'll stop having those thoughts and those feelings and those urges. Yeah. All right. Also, I'm doing this new thing. It's the Truth Support Network. That's where people who are really into the truth want to share it, and it's like, yeah, people aren't listening. Well, we're kind of getting together on this, and we've got our own forum, and forum's not quite ready, but it's getting there. It's almost there. Another week or two. Fast as I can. So it's all about presenting and promoting the truth movement, and camaraderie, and meeting like-minded individuals and all that. I've already got about 60, over 60 people are interested. They want to play. So it's going to be great. It's going to be a lot of, you know, interaction and doing different things and coming up with new strategies for sharing the truth and getting information out there and all that neat stuff. Okay, so that's it. That's me today. Thank you for watching. And comments, always welcome. And I will talk to you later. Really. Thanks for all the great comments I've been getting these days. You guys are awesome. Bye.